This is lesson 1.3, Finding Order in Life and Math. Today we're going to be looking at the order of operations. So our main focus is going to be on simplifying expressions via the order of operations. We'll also look at evaluating expressions, which also requires an understanding of order of operations. So, what happens if everyone follows different rules when they go up to the traffic lights? For example, maybe we have Ben, who when he sees red, he goes. When he sees yellow, he stops. When he sees green, he is cautious and starts to slow down or comes to a stop. And then you have Ethan, who follows sort of the normal set of rules that we're used to. Red, stop, yellow, caution, and green, go. What might happen? Well, if everybody's following different rules, then we probably end up with some sort of an accident. We have rules in life in order to keep us safe or so that we all follow the same sort of set of standards to get the same results at the end. Basically, we come to a common understanding of how we're going to function as a society. Here's another example to think about. What happens if you have two countries? And let's say that this country right here really likes something that the other country produces. And so let's say that the sellers, let's say they produce something that you really like chocolate. They have the best chocolate in the world. And so our country on the left, we'll call country A, they want to buy some chocolate from country, well, since it's chocolate, we might as well call it country C. And when they get the bill, for whatever reason, again, this is a hypothetical sort of imaginary situation, this is how the bill is presented, and then they have to calculate what the total is. And so notice that each country is going to calculate the bill a little bit differently. Country A is going to multiply first, and then is going to add in the 16 after that. And so they end up getting a total of $191. Country C, they do things a little bit differently, and they add first. And so then they get 21 times 35 to get a total of $735. So country C sends the bill over to country A and says, hey, we did the math. You owe us $735 for this shipment of chocolate that you ordered. Country A says, whoa, hey now, your chocolate's good, we really like it, but that's a little steep. And we did the math, and we only got $191 for our bill. So we're only going to pay $191. Country C says, sorry, we did the math, we have the finest math experts, in addition to our finest chocolate makers, and the bill is $735. If you want that chocolate, you're going to pay for it. Country A says, I don't think so. We have good accountants too. And they said $191. Your chocolate's good, but we're only paying $191. And they start arguing back and forth. And what might eventually happen if they keep arguing and fighting with each other? War might break out. And two countries destroy each other over chocolate bars and the wrong bill. Now, I know this is an excellent example, but it is a realistic situation in the sense that if you calculate a bill one way and get an answer, and the person you're ordering from calculates the bill differently and gets another total, and you have a disagreement, who's right, who's wrong? So, in math, we have sets of rules or orders of operations in this sense that we follow, so that we can all get the same results at the end of the problem. There's a set way that we've defined math operations to be performed, and we call that the order of operations. Some vocabulary. An expression is a combination of numbers and symbols and operations combined together to create a statement. There is no equal sign, though. So for example, 2x plus 3, that's an expression. Or you could have x squared minus 7, Or you could have 3 terms or 4 terms. What matters is that you have numbers, symbols, operations, no equal sign. Simplify is when you perform the math, add, subtract, multiply, divide, powers, exponents, roots later on in the year, and you combine like terms as much as you can. Evaluate means that you're going to substitute a number into the variable spot, and then you're going to simplify the expression. A simple example might look like this. Evaluate 3x if x equals 7. So what they're telling you is we have an expression of 3x, and they give us that the x value is 7. So you take the x value, you substitute it into its spot in the expression, and then you simplify by performing whatever operations that you have. In this case, it's just multiplication, and so you get 21. Today, we're going to be focusing primarily on the order of operations, which is a set of rules that we follow in order to perform the operations within mathematics. Do you remember the order of operations? There's an acronym that goes along with it and a little saying. So the first part of the order of operations is completing the grouping symbols. Now, you might have learned it as parentheses in the past, but now that we're in Algebra 1 and in later maths, there are other types of grouping symbols. So in addition to parentheses, you can have brackets. Typically, brackets are used when we have multiple sets of grouping symbols in one problem, or grouping symbols within our grouping symbols. Braces may be used as a grouping symbol. However, we will not be using them in this class. We will use braces for other types of notation. And then something perhaps new for you is a fraction bar. Notice how you have an operation in the numerator and denominator that need to be simplified, and then you can do the division last, which is that fraction bar. So it seems like it's acting like it breaks order of operations, but that fraction bar acts as a grouping symbol, separating the numerator and denominator from each other. After grouping symbols, you have simplifying the exponents or the powers. Then you move on to multiplication and division. Now, when you're dealing with multiplication and division, and with adding and subtracting, you have to make sure that you perform them from left to right. Meaning that if I would see division first, say 30 divided by 5 times 3 in this statement, you want to do the division first because it's what you run into first when you come in from the left side of the problem. Be careful of that. This is often one area where students make mistakes. Adding and subtracting is the same way. The saying that you are used to using with order of operations is PEMDAS, which is Please Excuse My Dear Aunt Sally. Now, PEMDAS is great, but it's not perfect. And what I mean by that is that the memory device. There's something that these letters do not indicate that are something important that you need to remember about the order of operations. From the last slide, do you remember what that is? It deals with the M and the D and the A and the S. Notice how nothing in PEMDAS indicates that you should do it from left to right when you're doing the multiplying and dividing and the adding and subtracting. So perhaps a good thing to do if you're writing out the letters of PEMDAS to help you remember the order of operations, that you actually write an arrow above the M and the D and then the A and the S to help you remember that it's from left to right. I would stress that you put 2 arrows to indicate that multiplying and dividing is one thing that you need to look at, and then adding and subtracting is the other set that you need to look at. So let's look at our first example. So if I look across the problem, you'll see that I have some multiplication, some grouping symbols, some division, some adding, and some powers. So the first thing I want to do is I want to take care of the things inside of the grouping symbols. So I get 5 times, well, 7 minus 5 is 2. Then I'll divide by 2 plus. Now, some students say, well, can I write 9 now? And the answer to that is yes. You don't have to do one operation per step and have like a 50-step problem. Now, basically, the main thing to look for is that if you want to do multiplication, division, or exponents, you can do them at the same time as long as they're separated by adding or subtracting. So since this exponent is separated from this grouping symbol by that addition sign, then I can do the parentheses, and I got 2, and I can do my exponent and get 9 at the same time and not run into any issues as far as breaking the order of operations. So now I'm ready to continue on. So if I look across from left to right, I have multiplication, division, addition. So I do the multiplication first, write down the rest of the problem. Then I'm going to divide, since division becomes before addition. So I get 5 plus 9, and then I finish it to get 14. So that expression simplifies down to 14. Just a quick reminder, in case you missed it, remember that with exponents, that means a number times itself when we're talking about a square. It does not mean multiplication times 2, which is something that students often mess up. So 3 squared means 3 times 3, and 3 times 3 is 9. So our next one is a fraction example. Remember, because we have multiple operations in the numerator and denominator, that fraction bar acts as a grouping symbol. So I'm going to simplify the numerator and denominator. Now, because my numerator and denominator are separated or grouped by that division bar, I can work on the numerator and denominator at the same time. And again, it cuts down on the number of steps that I need to write. If you're not comfortable doing multiple steps at a time, that's fine. In the denominator, I'm going to write the product of 4 times 3, which is 12. In the numerator, I have multiplication, so 3 times 5 is 15, and then plus the 9. Remember, multiplication comes before addition. I'm going to keep simplifying so I can add the numerator and get 24. Now that my numerator and denominator have been simplified down to one number, then I can go ahead and divide. So 24 divided by 12 is 2. This problem is for you to complete. So go ahead and pause the video, try the problem for yourself, and then resume the video to see the explanation. So did you get 60 as an answer? So in this problem, I had grouping symbols that I needed to take care of first, the 7 plus 3, and notice I wrote 10. Then in my second step, I had exponents with multiplication next to it, and then division at the end. So I needed to take care of those exponents before I could do the multiplying and dividing. So 10 squared is 100, and then you can see that I did 3 times 100 to get 300. And then 300 divided by 5 is 60. This problem is also yours to complete, so go ahead and pause the video and try the problem for yourself, and then resume the video to hear the explanation. So, did you get 18 as an answer? Now, in this problem, you'll notice in the first step, I had a grouping symbol with quite a bit of information inside of there. I had exponents, I had subtraction, and I had multiplication. Now, because my exponents and multiplication were separated by that minus sign, notice that I did both the squared and the multiplication at the same time, and you are allowed to do that. So I got 36 minus 21. I still needed to simplify the grouping symbols, so I did 36 minus 21 to get 15. So now I have multiplication, division and addition. And so I followed from left to right. I ran in the multiplication first and then the division. And so then I needed to do 8 times 15 to get 120. Then I divided by 8, since that was the next coming from left to right as far as multiplying and dividing was concerned. And I got 15, and then 15 plus 3 is 18. This problem is also for you to try. Notice in this problem, they want you to identify the mistake. When you're identifying and explaining mistakes, make sure that you refer to the mathematical rule that was done correctly or not correctly to justify your reasoning. Just saying that something is wrong and not justifying why it's wrong is not satisfactory. So go ahead and pause the video, try the problem for yourself, and then resume the video to see the explanation. So your answer might sound something like this. The student subtracted before division, breaking the order of operations, which states division is before subtraction. You could even go into more detail saying what specifically they subtracted before what was supposed to be divided and actually give those numbers. That would make the answer even better. And perhaps even indicating what step of the problem, so in the very first line and the very second line is where the mistakes occur in the problem. When you correctly simplify the expression, you end up getting 25. We will continue working on how to properly explain problems throughout the rest of the year. This completes the lesson. You are now ready to begin the homework.